Our next guest has become one of the hottest performers in the music industry.
Her music has landed her at the top of the charts, and Radio Disney has named her the next big thing, and so did Jordan, with more than 27 million views on YouTube, and all of this before her 16th birthday. Let's meet music sensation, Skylar Stecker.
Hi.
You are blowing up, girl.
Aw, thank you guys so much for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, and you're gonna sing for us a little bit later.
Yes, yeah, my new single, Only Want You.
Awesome.
Aren't you curious kind of how this whole thing began?
Yes, for sure.
With music?
Yeah.
Well, when I was 9 years old, I played piano, so I signed myself up for a talent show to play the piano. And when I was asked to sing, I was surprised because she was like, oh, I want to hear you sing. And I was like, I don't sing. And then I sang for her, found out that I got in for the singing. And then a week later, I sang in the talent show, and I immediately fell in love with it. And then from that point on, I just started doing national anthems all over Wisconsin and singing for everyone I could and trying to evolve and try to grow. And I just knew that that's what I wanted to do forever. And you know, I was gonna do whatever it took in order to reach my goals.
I actually saw you sing the national anthem at a Badger game.
Really?
I did, I remember it. You had such a good voice.
Oh my gosh.
And major presence, it was cool. So you were a Midwest girl, so you moved Midwest to LA, now you're living there.
Yes.
And how's that been? Is that a good transition or is
it kind of... I mean, we definitely miss my, you know, both my mom and my dad's side of the family are in Wisconsin, so, but we do come back a lot. So we get to see them still. But the weather, I mean, in California, is the sun is really nice. But that's just where the music industry more is for what I'm trying to do. So it's nice being around it all of the time.
Yeah. I got a chance to chat with your mom before. I didn't ask her if she's a Packer fan. If she said yes, I might
not. My manager is. He's a huge Packer fan.
See, and we were getting along earlier. I don't know. Things might have to change now. You know, one of the things I'm curious about is I've never achieved this status of fame where you're at right now. And at such a young age. It's really cool. How do you handle all that at such an early age in your life? I mean, you still have so much more to accomplish, but here you are at the apex with still more to do.
Well, I think I just love it so much. So it's so natural for me because I just get to do what I love to do every single day. And so I have so many goals for myself, and I'm always setting, like, when I cross one off the list, there's like 10 more that you know, appear. So I'm constantly I want to grow and, but yeah, it's so natural and I just love it. So I just kind of keep going and always stay true to who I am. And I just know that, you know, whatever's going to happen is going to happen as long as I work hard and, you know, stay true to who I am.
So with that fame, because comes some famous guys hitting you up, I'm sure.
Oh,
who is hitting up your phone right now?
I'll just put you on a spot.
No one really.
Oh.
No, I'm sorry. I don't have a really cool answer for that. But no, I mean, I'm single, but not really. Music is where I'm mingling.
Music is your boyfriend.
Music is my boyfriend. Yeah,
I'm too young for that stuff.
Well, yeah, and I'm just really focused on my music too. Like I choose. I mean, I could, but I don't. So my parents are glad. They're like, yes.
Good answer. You know, we talked about earlier. You know how there's the heavyweights in the game right now. You got the Beyoncés, the Rihannas, the Adeles. You're that next young wave. How do you feel about being responsible for bringing that next wave of music in
and
being a part of that group?
I'm very excited. Again, I just feel it's so exciting for me because I feel so passionate about what I do and the music that I put out there, and I always want to spread positivity. And I definitely see I have a lot of, you know, my fans and the moms will come up to me and say, thank you so much for being a good role model, which I want to continue to do. And I want to continue to be a really good role model for people throughout my whole entire career. So, yeah, I really want to do that. I really want to spread positivity.
Well, clearly, you're not in town for the Bears game. Your manager over there is a Packers fan. What are you in town for this weekend?
Well, I actually have a show this Sunday at the Rosemont Theater. So if you guys are in the area, make sure you go and come. It's going to be really fun.
Yes.
I'm excited.
And you're going to be performing for us later, so we have a little teaser, which is nice.
Yes.
But also, the song that you're performing is what?
Only Want You.
And what is
the
that about?
Single. Only Want You is about being in a relationship, which is funny because I haven't been in one, but I know what I do. It's about being in a relationship with somebody who you have these expectations to be this person you want them to be, and then they go and do something that's kind of screwed up, and you're like, oh, come on, I only want you. So I've definitely wanted to talk about that for a really long time, and now I get to do that with the song. So adds a little bit of a fun twist to it as well. So.
We only want you in our studio. I can't wait to hear you sing.
I only want to be here
played.
With you.
You got such a great vibe about you, great head on your shoulders.
Thank
such
you.
Destined for a big success. So I am right in predicting she's
the
next great
thing.
I'm on
the train. I'm with you.
She's already a big thing. She's going to be even bigger. Be sure to get your ticket info for Skylar's show this weekend at showofthesummer.com. Say right there, everybody. Skylar is in the building, and she's going to be performing later on.